Hi, my name's Emma Gaynor, exercise physiologist and pulmonary exercise manager here at the Lung Foundation. Welcome to our Maintaining Movement series, a great way to keep active at home and in your local community. Before starting any exercise, it's important you consult with your healthcare team and a registered exercise professional. Here at the Lung Foundation, we would like you to also look at our safety guidelines for exercising at home. These can be downloaded via our website. You can also use a guide like the Better Living with Your Exercise book here as a way to keep on track and know exactly how to do your exercises in line with your exercise professional. Today, we're going to continue to work on our falls prevention and balance exercises. As we've previously said, working on falls prevention is important as we age, our risk increases. Particularly for those who have been on long-term steroid use, like many people with a chronic lung condition, we want to decrease the chance of falls, as you will find that your bones will be quite brittle and may break easier than others. For all these exercises today, it's suggested that you aim for 10 to 12 and two lots of each. We do, however, stress that it is important that you're working with an accredited exercise physiologist or physiotherapist to develop a program that's right for you. Now let's start with some ankle rolls. One ankle at a time, we're going to make circles, moving in a clockwise position. This is a great warm-up for any falls prevention and balance exercise programs. Making sure your ankles are very flexible with decreased chance of falls. Once you've done clockwise, moving to anti-clockwise. For this warm-up, we're going to aim for 30 seconds. Once you've done the right side, work on the left. To continue our warm-up, we're now going to do some sidestepping. Make sure that you've got a stable surface in front of you like a bench. We're going to start going to the right and to the left. To challenge your balance, hover your hands up and try not to use any support at all. Aiming for around 30 seconds is a good idea. Now let's do a side step up. Make sure you're using a stable step or a fixed stair and always have something to grab onto. To start with, we're going to be in line with the staircase and our toes will be facing forward. We're going to bring one leg up at a time and ensure that the second leg follows. So bringing it up and pushing forward. You'll see that my toes track forward and stay pointing in the same direction. Make sure that we aim for the same amount on each side. So you may need to turn around to do the same amount on each leg. Now let's do a squat. We're going to start with our feet shoulder width apart. For today, I'm going to have my hands across the chest. Make sure though, if you need more support, there is a stable surface around you, like a sturdy chair or a bench. From this position, with toes pointing in the same direction, hands across the chest, we're going to bend at the hip and the knee at the same time, driving the weight through your heels. Coming to that point and slowly up. Make sure in that downward position, your knees aren't past your toes and you're driving. Breathing would be in as we come down and out on the way up. Now the side view for this would look like this. Feet shoulder width apart, hands across the chest, slowly down and back up. So now we're going to work on some heel raises. To make it harder, we're going to do one leg at a time. Moving in front of a bench or a stable chair, we want to link one foot behind the other and slowly bring your heel up, holding it at the top for a moment, and slowly down. With your breathing, you want to take a breath in, and as we come up, which is the hardest point, purse lips out. To make it a little harder, Move from two hands to two fingers, or one finger, or if you want a bigger challenge, you may not have any hands at all. Now let's look at doing a tandem stance, or otherwise known as a heel to toe stance. Make sure you've always got something stable to hold on to. One foot in front of the other, so your feet are touching, and we're going to be in alignment. From this position, you can either put one hand on the chair, one finger, or no hands at all. If no hands at all is too easy, you might want to challenge yourself a little bit further. You can do this by using a ball and throwing it from one hand to the other. You may want to stand on a cushion or a foam padding, or to challenge yourself even further, closing your eyes. Remember, only work within your limits and always have a stable surface to grab onto, and ensure you're aiming for 30 seconds. Now let's make that tandem stance a little bit harder. We're going to be moving and doing a heel to toe motion at the same time. So the best way to do this is to be in a kitchen where you may have a long bench or something to hold onto the whole way through. Today I'm going to visualize that there's a bench here in line with this chair. To start with, we're going to have one foot in front of the other and slowly move forward in a straight line. If you can, try and keep your head up as you go down. Then from the end, we're going to go backwards. Again, making sure that there is support on at least one side. Our last balance exercise today is a single leg stance. To start with, make sure you're holding on for support and then gradually build it up and take your hand away where you feel comfortable. So holding on for that support, trying to make sure it is a bench that is fixed. Bring one leg off the floor, holding it there. Slowly take that support away and see how long you can hold it. I'm a little bit wobbly there, as you can see. So if you're wobbly at that point, use a finger and aim for as long as possible. To make that harder, as I suggested previously, we could stand on a cushion or a pad. You could close your eyes if you're very advanced, or you could throw a ball as you're standing on one foot. Now let's finish off with a standing quad stretch. To do this stretch, it's best standing, holding onto a stable surface. We need to bend at the knee and bring our ankle back. Best to grab the foot if you can, tuck your knees together, and bring your foot as far back as you can as possible, bringing the chest up and your hips in. If you find it hard to bring that leg up, you can use a supportive device like a towel or a therapy band. Let's have a look at that on the side with the therapy band. For these stretches, you want to hold for 30 seconds and alternate sides. To review further stretches, make sure to look at our stretching exercises in this maintaining movement series.